Word is brought to the palace that Orestes has been killed in a chariot race. A messenger has brought the news, and with it the ashes of Orestes. Clytemnestra, the guilty queen, freed from the fear of her son's vengeance, rejoices openly. But Electra, her last hope gone, mourns over the funeral urn in which, she has been told, her brother's ashes have been bestowed. Oh, sad memorial of a life I prized beyond all other lives. Oh, loved Orestes, how much this coming home belies the hope with which I sent you forth, so young, so bright, O child, and now this nothing which I hold so lightly in my hands. Would I had died before I sent you out to dwell far off with strangers. Better you had died that day and shared our father's grave than perished thus miserably in homeless banishment far from my care. Alas, these hands of mine, which should have bathed and dressed you lovingly, then from the hungry flames have gathered in grief's precious load for burial. Not so. Some stranger did my office. All I have is this, a little dust, a paltry urn. Alas, for all my care, my loving care, proved useless now. One day you died, unmourned, unwrapped in sepulchre, and in that one day gathered up my life and like a whirlwind left me utterly forlorn. Our father's dead, you are gone, our foes exult. And she, our mother, most unmotherly, runs mad for joy. The luckless fate that haunts us both has stolen hope away and left me for that bright form that trod the sunlit heights, these ashes, and a shade that cannot help. Ah me, alas. Oh, pitiful and strange. Alas, alas, oh dearest, by what terrible ways you've traveled, thus to join the sunless dead. Come, welcome me to this same narrow room which houses you, my ashes mixed with yours. In life we shared and shared alike. Now I would share your grave and never part from you again. I see only the dead can feel no pain.